Hello everyone! This video will be the first in a series of three videos about some aspects of my master's thesis. We will not go into too much details as this might be too complicated for some of the viewers, and secondly, there are some material that might be relevant for a paper we're working on, so I'm not going to talk about that. If we publish the paper, I could do a video about it, so let me know in the comments what you think about that. As some of you might know, I did a theoretical master's thesis with the topic dark matter via a Higgs portal. I will touch on many topics which we have already discussed in this channel previously, so I will not go into too much details, but I will put a link in the description if you want to learn more about these topics. In this video, we're going to focus on creating a theory. So how do we write theories in terms of math and then interpret the physics of the theory? So stay tuned for that. Physics is great because we can explain many things, like how water flows or how rockets fly into space. There are, however, many things we still don't understand, so there are still plenty of problems to solve in physics. The best theory we have today is the standard model, which is extremely successful in explaining most physics we have. There are, however, limits to its success, and certain aspects are not explained. There is one problem called the missing mass problem, which has existed for more than 100 years. It relates to the fact that when looking around the universe, galaxies and galaxy clusters behave as if there are additional matter in the universe that we can't see. This led to the idea of several theories, but one of the most prevalent one is the one of dark matter. The idea is that there is indeed some extra matter which is not accounted for by the standard model and which we cannot see. In my thesis, we look at possible model extensions of the standard model which can add such dark matter particles to the standard model and solve this missing mass problem. There are many models to consider, but the one I looked at could possibly also address some other problems in physics, like the hierarchy problem and the baryon asymmetry. The standard model is based on gauge theory, which is a fancy word of saying that it's based on symmetry. Symmetries like you and your mirror image can be expressed in terms of some specific math called group theory. A group represents some specific symmetry. And without going into the details, the standard model is based on three gauge groups. Now, the cool thing about groups is that they explain vector bosons or force carriers of the theory. And as it turns out, the three gauge groups of the standard model directly relate to the three forces, namely the strong, weak, and electromagnetic force. Now, we also have particles that arise due to different math, but what if we add more symmetry groups to the standard model? That is what I looked at, and indeed you can make a model which contains a dark matter candidate like this. So that was some background information and theory about how we construct models in physics. So how do we actually write a theory? Well, a common way to write a fundamental theory is using a Lagrangian. This is basically an energy equation for different components of the theory. I looked at two models based on different gauge symmetry groups as an extension to the standard model. Let's now look at the simplest model with the U1 group extension. This might look like a bit of a mouthful, but let's go step by step. First, we have the standard model. So this term represents the enormous Lagrangian of the standard model, but without the Higgs potential. I will get to that soon. We don't have to care much about this part because this is just the usual physics. The next terms are more interesting and part of the new theory. We have this D and phi term. Phi is a new scalar field that this model also includes. And this is, in short, like a new type of Higgs particle, a second one. The D hides the coupling to our new vector boson, phi mu, which is our dark matter particle. Thus, the second term connects the new Higgs particle to the dark matter particle. It's an interaction term. The third term is the Higgs potential, and since we now have two Higgs-type particles, we both have the standard model Higgs particle H and the new one called phi. Finally, we have this new term with our gauge field of our dark matter vector boson, and we will now go into more details about these different terms. The Higgs potential of the Standard Model is essential as it leads to the fundamental masses of the particles. The Standard Model Higgs was finally discovered in 2012 and has the mass around 125 GeV. This was the last piece of the Standard Model, but the Standard Model Higgs turns out to be a bit odd, as it leaves some questions unanswered. To improve on that, a new Higgs potential is considered with an additional Higgs particle 5. The potential at the end of the day does the same thing. It generates symmetry breaking and thus causes fundamental masses. Thus we get massive particles like the massive quarks and electrons. But there are some details that makes this 2 Higgs potential a bit more favorable, even though it's a bit more complicated. An obvious question is how the Standard Model is now connected to the dark matter sector. In other words, how does the Standard Model couple to the dark matter vector boson particle? We just discussed the Higgs part, and one of the reasons we need this new Higgs potential is that we get a way to connect the Standard Model particle, which we know exists, to a new Higgs, which is hypothetical. How does this help, you might ask? Well, now we can connect the dark matter particle to the new hypothetical Higgs, and thus via the Higgs, the dark matter connects to the Standard Model. That is why the title is Dark Matter via Higgs Portal. The connection between the Higgs particles comes via the second term in our equation. The last term with the gauge field is not so interesting in the U1 model, but in the U2 model it leads to some extra physics, some additional physics. Now, writing down a theory is one thing, exploring it is another. To investigate the model, we must consider the physics it leads to, and for that we must consider the interactions of the model and the Feynman diagrams. We of course have the same physics as in the Standard Model, but we now have some extra diagrams. As mentioned before, the interaction term leads to a connection between the dark matter and the Higgs particles. And actually, there are some details in the theory that leads to the dark matter also connecting ever so slightly with the Standard Model Higgs. Then the Higgs potential leads to interactions between the two Higgs particles, but the decay depends on the actual mass of this new phi Higgs. And this is a parameter which is not known a priori. So these diagrams lead to some new phenomena that one can then explore to then see how this model works in practice. So in this video we looked at how physicists look at some problem and then, based on some underlying math, construct a new theory in an attempt to resolve the problem. In particular, I hope you understand better how we can write a theory mathematically in terms of a Lagrangian. While I don't show explicitly how this leads to the Feynman diagrams, I hope you get an idea of how certain math leads to certain diagrams, which leads to some physical phenomena, and in the next video we will look at what kind of phenomena might be interesting to investigate. I also hope it's clear that when developing a new theory, it is important that a new theory contains the progress of the previous theory. So when we try to make a new theory, it is important that this new theory can reproduce the same result as the previously rigorously tested theory. So on that note, I hope you liked the video. If you want to support the channel, check the link in the description. Otherwise, like and subscribe. Other than that, I hope you will tune in again, so stay tuned. Bye.